So here's what I'd like to talk about today. And first I have to disclose, I have developed, from reading all these FOIA requests and FBI files, I've developed a certain love, some would call it a fetish, for old FBI memos and styles and things. And so, you know, you're going to see this kind of throughout, because it's kind of, I spend much of my life seemingly living in the 1960s and 1970s reading old memos where things were sent by teletype. But so what I'd like to do today is tell you a little bit, just for those of you who are not present for the 1960s and 1970s, tell you a little bit of a background about phone phreaking. I'd then like to describe some of my Freedom of Information Act travails and experiences and fun things. And then I'm going to go off the record and tell you all the stuff that's not in the book, and then conclude with a few lessons learned. And the lessons learned are not just for those of you writing history books, which I can tell you is not a particularly lucrative or good way to spend your time, but it's for any big creative project, but especially anyone that has kind of any sort of historical bent to it. And for any of you who may be worried, I just want to stress that all information contained herein is unclassified, at least according to FBI Declassification Guide 60324, who sounds like he should be working for the Department of Homeland Security with a name like that.
Testing this.
Here's the background.
Lucent Technologies phone machine.
Let's see, why is it my
speakerphone 925?
This is beautiful. So when the FBI sends you something under the Freedom of Information
speakerphone 925,
they scan it in.
Doesn't need batteries or
electronically. And their scanner has this amazing way of taking old black and white photographs and making them look just so cool.
16.
But admire this for just a moment.
And 16.
Imagine a world
phone
where a telephone receiver ends up with an FBI evidence tag on it, right? I mean,
Project
how does
MF?
That happen?
And this
and it turns
is
out there are several reasons
how good the speakerphone sounds, which is pretty damn good.
Now, if you are a normal person, you look at that and you think, oh, well, you know, that's an old rotary phone, whatever. It's a phone, right? It's not that interesting. It's not something you spend any time thinking about.
Here's the
in the words of phone freak Evan Dorbell, it is not something that is interesting
and
enough
function
to be
interested
app. In at all.
In this case,
you
I use
blue I
box.
You are not a
blue box function.
And so, to me, this represents not a rotary phone.
Project MF.
It represents
that's some good shit right there.
Because if you have a certain mental defect, like many of us do, you look at something like that and you say, "Wow, I wonder how that works. I wonder where it goes to. I wonder what happens if you take it apart. I wonder what happens if you use it in ways that it was not intended to be used. I wonder what happens
focus,
if you dial numbers that are not in the phone book. I wonder what happens if you play with it. Where do those wires go? How does that all work?"
Oops.
In addition, if that's not enough, they made it more tantalizing, because in the old days, if you played